going to start our week, just like we do every time, with our next lesson video. So stay tuned and check it out. See you guys tomorrow.
I'm Bobby and I grew up on my family's farm. I moved to the big city, let adventure take me far. It's Hobbies with Bobby. Bobby, yeah! This is Hobbies with Bobby.
Hi, I'm so thankful to have you on the farm with me. Last week, we learned that friends can help our faith grow. My brother and his friends, when I was exhausted, they came and they helped me remodel the goat pen. Check out these before photos and the ones of what it looks like now. We did so much together. Well, the county fair is coming up, and I'm going to start getting my animals ready for the competition. My brother said we should only bring our prettiest, our biggest, and our best goats. But I want to bring Tiny Goat. She's not the biggest or the best, but she is the friendliest. I wonder if there's anyone in the Bible who has something to say about what I should do. Do you think the Bible can teach us something today?
Yeah!
Well, okay then. Let's do it.
It's Bible time. Time for the Bible, yeah!
It's Bible time with Bobby.
The book of Acts tells a story that happens after Jesus died on the cross, came back to life, and went up to heaven. Two of his followers, named John and Peter, were walking everywhere telling everyone about Jesus. They even healed a man who couldn't walk. The local religious leaders, they disagreed with what they were doing, and so John and Peter, they were brought in for questioning. That could be a scary moment, that they were full of courage from God. In front of everyone, they said, "It is by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, but whom God raised from the dead, that this man stands before you healed. Jesus is the stone you builders rejected, which has become the cornerstone. Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to humankind by which we must be saved." John and Peter told the truth about Jesus to everyone who was there to listen. And you know what happened? The religious leaders, they realized that Peter and John were just ordinary, normal guys and decided they shouldn't do anything to them. So they let John and Peter go. I think I understood all of that, except the part about builders and stones. What did that have to do with anything? Maybe Farmer Mason can help explain that to us.
There has to be more here.
There has to be more here.
Hello, everyone. That's a great question, Bobby. The first time I had that Bible verse read to me, I asked the very same question. To find out what Jesus is saying, it helps to see some real rocks. Come with me. In Bible times, big buildings were made out of stone and rocks. In order to make sure all the walls in the whole building would be straight, they had to start with the best rock. They would map out on the ground like this where to put the walls and then place that very best rock in the whole pile right there in the corner. That very best rock would become known as the, can you guess it?
Cornerstone.
That's right, as the cornerstone. The builders would look at all the stones and reject most of them, and then they would choose their very favorite or best stone. If they built on a rock like this, like a funky or crooked rock, then all the walls would be thrown off. It would be pretty shocking to the people hearing this Bible verse to think that a stone that the builders threw away, like this one, they throw this one away, could become the most important stone, the cornerstone. So when Peter and John say that line about the cornerstone, they're actually quoting a Bible verse from a psalm about God saving God's people through the Lord. They are calling Jesus the cornerstone of God's plan. And their example shows that we can tell God's story about God using the things that this world doesn't value to bring God praise, just like the cornerstone. I hope that helps you understand the builders and the cornerstone, Bobby.
Wow, that is pretty amazing that God chooses to use the rejected, small, and funky rocks to build upon. But if I'm not a builder, what does this Bible verse mean for me? Okay, when I go to the fair, I will look for ways to share with others about God's love for me and about Jesus' love for all people, all land, and all the animals. And based on what Peter and John said about the cornerstone, I am going to bring Tiny Goat to the fair anyways. Maybe God will do something amazing through her, even though she's not the biggest or the best. Stay tuned. I'll tell you how it goes. Guess what? I knew that Tiny Goat was not going to win the best goat at the fair. So we decided to just have a great time. I walked her around to visit all the other animals and their owners, and I met a ton of people. And Tiny Goat really enjoyed making everyone happy. Then the award show came. They did all the other awards for the biggest and the best animals, and of course, Tiny Goat didn't win anything. But then they gave out one more award for the animal out of all the animals that had the nicest personality. Tiny Goat won the friendliest animal of the whole fair. Yay! I got invited up into the front to get this ribbon, and then everyone who hadn't met her yet wanted to know about Tiny Goat. So I told him about how busy and distracted I was doing chores a couple weeks ago. I realized that the Tiny Goat just wanted to spend some time with me. I felt encouraged by my brother when he reminded me that I can help other people's faith grow when I share God's story. God loves me, so I told everyone that I met that God loved them too. It was amazing. If God can work through my little rejected goat, then for sure God can work through you and me too. I don't know what opportunity you'll have this week, but when we sense someone needs God's love, we can always share God's story. What a cool week. I'm so glad you were here for it. Come hang out next week, and we'll see what else we can get into. See you soon.
This is Hobbies with Bobby.
Thank you.